Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, and please be seated. Now, for a moment of silence. Thank you, and now to our news anchors.
Good morning, Warriors, and welcome to WOW TV. My name is Gavin.
And my name is Will. And today is Thursday, December 14th.
Now here's Olivia with the weather.
Thanks, Gavin and Will. Hey, Warriors, my name is Olivia. The weather for today will be a high of 71 and a low of 62. But who knows? I could be wrong. Have a great rest of your day, Warriors. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Olivia.
Just a reminder that if you haven't purchased your yearbook, you could buy one now for $75 on SchoolPay or yearbookfever.com. Prices go up January 1st to $85.
Seniors, have you taken your senior photo yet? If you haven't, you could be left out the yearbook. Don't let that be you. Make sure you sign up at katie.com and use code 24WestOrange10 for $10 off your sitting fee.
Now here is Sam with National Sports.
Thanks, Gavin and Will. What's up, Warriors? My name is Sam here with National Sports News. The AFC playoff race is getting tighter week after week, and week 14 was no exception. Six teams with 7-6 records are fighting for their conference's final two wildcard spots. Every team in the AFC North is above 500, although the Ravens have opened up a two-game lead over the Browns for the first place. In the South, the Texans and Colts are both within a game of first-place Jacksonville, and by virtue of Sunday's loss to the Bills, the Chiefs' lead over Denver in the AFC West is down to a single game. Moving forward, the Dolphins have a tough upcoming schedule that includes games against the Cowboys, Ravens, and Bills, and that Week 17 game between Miami and Baltimore may determine who earns the conference's coveted playoff bye. The Steelers and Bengals both have games on Saturday that could be considered must-win, while the Browns and Broncos are two wildcard contenders that are sitting pretty right now. Two teams that could certainly use a light remaining schedule is Kansas City and Jacksonville, who have both lost two straight games. Jacksonville's schedule, however, isn't as easy as one would think. The Bills kept their playoff hopes alive by beating the Chiefs this past weekend, while things for the Texans look a little rough in the coming weeks after C.J. Stroud has been placed in the concussion protocol. There's still a lot of football to be played, however, and the AFC playoff race continues this weekend. That's all for today's National Sports News. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Sam.
Come join Bingo Club at the final meeting before next semester today. They'll have Christmas-themed bingo games, snacks, and prizes. Everyone is welcome to come join the fun. Bingo Club meets right after school in room 531.
The West Orange Hip Hop Dance Team is having tryouts part two today and tomorrow from 2:30 to 3:30. Today, come learn audition, dance choreography, and tomorrow review and perform the dance in groups. Tryouts will be in the gym hallway.
NHS is hosting Flick on the Field tomorrow at 7 p.m. The gates will open at 6:20, and for entry, you can either pay $5 or bring three canned goods. Tickets include hot chocolate and popcorn, and this year's movie is Elf.
The FFA holiday chapter meeting is December 20th at 1:20 p.m. For the cookie potluck party, bring in homemade or store-bought cookies.
The library is selling Krispy Kreme donuts on Wednesdays. They're $1 each or $12 for a dozen. We'll have 25 dozen to sell. School pay will be available the day of sale. Money raised allows the Media Center to purchase books. Thanks for supporting the library.
Are you looking for additional help in your classes or your homework? Check out after-school tutoring from 2:30 to 3:30. See the schedule on the screen for times and room numbers.
Thanks for watching WOW TV.
Have a terrific Thursday, and be sure to tune in tomorrow. You and me, we got the world to see, so come on down.